गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, वेलकम टू स्वाता एस अकेडमी। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द एमसीक्यूज ऑफ 3rd June एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो जॉइन अस ऑन आवर टेलीग्राम चैनल वेयर वी अपलोड ऑल दीज पीपीटीज एंड देन यू कैन डू मल्टीपल रिविजन ऑफ दैम। सो लेट्स सी वॉट आर द 10 टॉपिक्स विच वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन टूडेज लेक्चर। सो हेयर इज द लिस्ट इज गिवन एंड ट्राई टू गेट एटलीस्ट 7 क्वेश्चन करेक्ट आउट ऑफ 10। सो वर्क हार्ड, बी कंसिस्टेंट, रेगुलरली वॉच आवर वीडियोज। So let's begin our today's lecture. So question number 1 is with reference to Competition Commission of India. Statement first, CCI is a constitutional body whose jurisdiction extends to the whole of India. Second, it aims to prevent the activities that have an adverse effect on competition in India. So here the correct option is B, that means statement second is correct, but statement first is incorrect. Because CCI is a statutory body, not a constitution body, and it was established under the Act. And its aim is to prevent the activity that has or have an adverse effect on competition in India. And the name of the Act was Competition Act 2002. And it is a tool to prevent and punish anti-competitive business practices by firms and unnecessary government interference in the market. And the context is that CCI is looking into allegations that Google is abusing its market position to unfairly promote its mobile payment app in the country. Now question number 2 is with reference to defamation. Statement first, defamation case is a legal claim involving injury to one's reputation caused by a false statement. Second, in case of civil and criminal defamation, the punishment includes imprisonment or fine or both. So here the correct option is A, that means statement second is incorrect. And statement second is incorrect because there are two type of defamation in India, including civil and criminal. But in case of civil defamation, there is no punishment in the form of jail sentences. Whereas criminal defamation includes sentenced to 2 years imprisonment or fine or both. And if we see the meaning of defamation, it is the term for a legal claim involving injury to one's reputation caused by a false statement of fact, which includes both written or spoken. And context is that the Madras High Court stated that civil servants and constitutional functionaries must be able to face criticism and cannot misuse the law of criminal defamation against their adversaries. Now question number 3 is with reference to dugong. Statement first, dugong is a herbivorous marine species that graze on seagrass in shallow coastal waters. Second, the IUCN status of the species is endangered. So here the correct option is A, that means statement second is incorrect, because the IUCN status of dugong or a sea cow is vulnerable, not endangered, and it is a herbivorous mammal or marine species. As you can see in the image, this is the image of dugong or sea cow, and it grazes on sea grass. But there are many threats to dugong, which includes human activities such as destruction and modification of habitat, pollution, illegal fishing activities, poaching and unplanned tourism. And context is that World Dugong Day was observed on 28 May to raise awareness about their decreasing number. So as of now, their IUCN status is vulnerable. Now question number 4 is, World Hunger Day observed on 28 May is an initiative of which of the following organization? So the correct option is A, that means Hunger Project. And the aim of the initiative is to spread awareness about chronic hunger and find sustainable solution to hunger and poverty. And if we talk about sustainable development agenda, goal number 2 of 2030 SDGs seeks to end hunger and all forms of malnutrition and double agricultural productivity in the next 15 years. And India ranked at 102nd position in Global Hunger Index, and still 69% of death of children under 5 in India is due to malnutrition. Now question number 5 is, which of the following types of unemployment is caused by structural or supply side factor? So the correct option here is C, that means it is a natural unemployment. Also, natural unemployment reflects the number of people that are unemployed due to the structure of the labor force, such as those replaced by technology or those who lack certain skills to gain employment. And the natural rate of unemployment is unemployment caused by supply side factor rather than demand side factor. Now question number 6 is, recently the world's greenest stimulus plan was in news. Statement first, the program will be launched by the EU. Second, the proposal will invest in energy efficient renovation, clean transportation and renewable energy. Third, it needs to be approved by the bloc's 27 member states. Fourth, the aid can be used for reskilling of workers. So here the correct option is D, because all the given statements are correct. And the European Commission is set to transform its Green Deal strategy to reach net zero GHG emission by 2050 into a coronavirus economic rescue plan that will rapidly drive private investment and create jobs across the continent. And it would promote sustainable investment in synchronous with the EU's climate and energy target, and a move that was missing in many national COVID-19 bailouts despite encouragement from the Commission. Now question number 7 is, you have to consider the following statements regarding desert swamps. Statement first, desert locusts normally live and breed in semi-arid or desert region. Second, for laying eggs, they require bare ground. Third, they are more likely to breed in the Indo-Gangetic plains. So we have to choose the incorrect statement. So here the option will be C, because statement third is incorrect, as desert locusts are more likely to breed in Rajasthan than in the Indo-Gangetic plains or Kaveri or Godavari Delta. And locusts aren't dangerous as long as they are individual hoppers or small isolated groups of insects in what is called the solitary phase, and it is when their population grow to large number, the resultant crowding induces behavioral change and transformation from the solitary to gregarious phase that they start forming swarms. And this scenario happens only when the conditions turn very favorable in their natural habitat, that is desert and semi-arid region, and these areas should get rainfall that will produce enough green vegetation to enable both egg laying and hopper development. Now question number 8 is, recently National Institute of Mental Health and Neurosciences, that is NIMHANS, was in news. Statement first, it is the apex center for mental health and neuroscience education in the country. Second, the institute operates autonomously under the Ministry of Human Resource and Development. So here the correct option is A, because statement second is incorrect, as the institute operates autonomously but under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, not Ministry of HRD. So this statement would be very confusing, so do remember it. And it is a premier medical institution which is located in Bengaluru, and the priority gradient adopted at the institute is service, manpower, development and research. Now question number 9 is, consider the following statement regarding zonal council, and you have to choose the incorrect one statement. So the incorrect one statement here is B, that means 6 zonal councils were set up under States Reorganization Act 1956, because under this act, 5 zonal councils were set up, not 6, and the Northeast state are not included in the zonal council. Their special problem are looked after by the Northeastern Council, which was set up under Northeastern Council Act 1972. And each zonal council has set up a standing committee constituting of chief secretaries of the member states of their respective zonal councils. So do remember that North Eastern Council is not set up under the State Reorganization Act 1956. Now question number 10 is, which of the following countries shares border with Thailand? So here the correct option is D, that means none of the above, because Thailand shares boundary with Cambodia, Laos, Malaysia and Myanmar. And although neither China nor Vietnam border Thailand, their territory lies within the 100 km of Thai territory, as you can see in the map. Now today's question for you is, you have to tell who is the chairman of Zonal Council. So that's all in our today's MCQs. Hope you guys are liking the lecture. And if you want to contact us, these are the details. And here is the link of Telegram channel is given. And you can also find the link in the description box below. And please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the latest update of the videos. Please like, comment and share the video. And if you want information regarding UPPSC examination and its test series, you can also contact us. So stay safe, stay healthy, have a nice day and thank you.